Hi everyone, I'm Shikin. Welcome back to our channel. Let's make a bit of throwback. A year before, we did a video on our channel titled Using Biofloc for Mud Crab Aquaculture. We realized that we received so many questions regarding this. One of the questions is from Helena Stock. What is the result after 1 year? Can you update on this? Do you think this will work? And do you provide any training on this? So in this video, we will share with you the results and update. In the last video, we show you with the Thai crab inside the biofloc. During the cultivation, we realized that to check whether the crab is still alive or not, it is quite difficult for the operator. As the brown color of biofloc makes the water visibility lesser, sometimes it is hard to check the crab by observation. This means we need to spend more time checking the crab condition, especially when we cultivate soft shell crab using the smile box. We put 3 to 4 crab in one crab house. Soft shell crab cultivation needs frequent check for the molting crab to harvest to avoid hardening of the shell. Besides, in biofloc, enough aeration is needed not only to increase dissolved oxygen but also for the circulation. Due to the presence of log and solid, good circulation is required to make sure resuspended of the solid in the water. Bad circulation will make the area that is full of suspended solid become anaerobic and lack of oxygen. In fact, culture the crab inside the box, meaning we are lack of circulation and the leftover feed will accumulate inside the box. This is risky as the ammonia level might be high during the leftover accumulation. Although inside the crab house also have the water inlet and outlet, it is still not enough to resuspend the solid particle. You might be thinking of culturing the crab in an open tank or pond with biofloc, but it might not be economical to do so as the main problem of culturing mud crab in an open pond method is cannibalism. Intensive aeration systems are required for the biofloc technology in the open pond system and can account to 28 to 30 horsepower for every hectare of pond. However, due to the low soaking density of crab in the open pond method, the profit from the culturing crab might not be able to cover the utility costs associated with maintaining the biofloc. Having that said, the biofloc technology will be more economical when applied to other species like baname or tilapia, which have a high feed cost. Another difficulty operating mud crab culture with biofloc is due to maintenance required for the piping system. We know that biofloc is full of beneficial bacteria and algae population. Even so, this microorganism can form biofilm on the piping surface due to some preferable condition. This biofilm formation can be easily removed if formed on the tank surface. However, if it forms inside the pipe and not being detected early, it will cause clog and disturb the water flow. The biofilm community can be formed within hours. So we believe that culturing the mud crab with the system that required a lot of piping will cause difficulty during the period of culture. Despite the difficulties to operate vertical mud crab farming with biofloc, it is also proof that the mud crab can grow better in the biofloc system. Some studies reported that the addition of algae in the system helped to increase the survival rate of mud crab due to the microorganism role to improve water quality and increase livelihood, meaning it also improved the feed conversion ratio. Interestingly, got some recent study already tried biofloc for sea cucumber cultivation. They reported that biofloc is proven to provide a sustainable protein source in the sea cucumbers diet. We usually heard the biofloc technology applied for shrimp, tilapia and catfish culture. But we at RAS Aquaculture believe that this technology can benefit other organism cultures as well. To succeed this assumption, modification and invention are needed to improve the problem that arise during the culture. As for capturing mud crab with bioflop, improvement should be made to solve the circulation and cannibalism behavior of the crab. That's all for this video. If you want to know more about bioflop, we provide free ebook for you to download. You can find the link in the description. Thank you for watching.